And the opening speaker will be Denis Daronin, our Chief Technical Officer here at Yolantis. Denis will delve into the most common business challenges and discuss how they can be addressed through specific architectural decisions. And he will also present the architecture of the IoT accelerator and explain its technological benefits, which allow businesses to speed up their time to market and reduce development costs. Denis, welcome to the IoT Landscape Live event. The stage is yours.
Hi, everyone. Thank you, Victor. Hi, everyone, again, and welcome to our today's webinar. I'm honored to start our IoT meetup today. And actually, through today's sessions, as Victor mentioned it, we will explore cutting-edge trends and share valuable insights regarding IoT. So thank you, everyone, for joining us today. And let's make this webinar informative and inspiring for all of us. So, as we mentioned it, our first topic for today is modular IoT data processing. So, why IoT platform? We actually built multiple IoT platforms for our clients, and during different projects, we observed several patterns that may be used across a wide range of IoT domains. We asked ourselves a simple question: how can we save up to 45% on architectural design and actually basic implementation? Is it possible to do? Is it possible to build some sort of platform or accelerator that will be flexible enough to support business scalability? Let's take a look. But before we jump into the topic, I would like to spend just a couple of minutes telling about who we are. So, Yolantis is a full-scale company founded in 2008 that provides end-to-end consulting and delivery services. We are focused on domain and technology consulting, and as part of our delivery services, we can become development partner and staffing partner. Our key differentiator is scalability. So actually, we have multiple cases when we built a team from zero up to 50 people within the first months of our engagement, or even up to 150 people within a couple of months. It's also important to mention that we are ISO certified company. So, as I mentioned it, we can take two primary roles. We can become consultant, so we provide set of advisory services like strategy design, business valuation service, and technical solution design. And as provider, we can focus on delivering solutions on different stages: prototyping, assessment, migration, cloud modernization, and of course, end-to-end implementation services. We are not limited to particular technology or language. We are a diverse company that can suggest you actually appropriate technical stack of your choice. Continuing topic of our capabilities, Yolantis has more than 500 in-house developers. We have delivery centers in three different countries: Poland, Ukraine, Cyprus, and we have a sales office in Estonia. So, without further ado, let's return back to our main topic. First, I would like to start with a little bit of background in IoT. So, typically, when we are speaking about technical or technological subdomains in IoT, we can define some sort of six main areas. The first one is connectivity, when we are speaking about different protocols and communication from edge devices to some platforms or between edge devices. Speaking about device management, the main task is to provision, monitor, or update your devices, right? So that's the main goal of this technical domain. As for embedded development, of course, here we are focusing on developing firmware or developing custom applications for your edge devices. Basically, the last three services are related to interconnection of everything you have in terms of physical devices with your end users. So data management, really essential component of any IT system that can actually data and build valuable insights out of what you have on your edge devices. Application development service or direction where you're actually focusing on developing end-to-end flows for your users. And middleware, that is essentially data routing, or sometimes middleware is used for data transformation and aggregation. So how can we help with our modular platform? So actually our platform introduces new architectural style for IT systems based on our previous experience and based on what we observed so far. So we will tackle basically 4 out of 6 main directions. We will speak today about connectivity, data management, application development, and middleware. So that's basically essential parts that are handled by our platform. Let's take a closer look. So first we will dive into technical details, starting from our business architecture. Actually, our platform operates on 5 different tiers that are designed in a way that they can be interchangeable and isolated from each other. So everything really starts from devices tier, where you have actually your physical devices, edge devices, that are streaming data, sending you some statuses about how it operates, make some periodical events. So that's essentially a place where you are generating your data. Then actually our platform starts with data collection tier. So essentially our platform acting as an entry point for your data from devices. We collect the data and we then push the data to the next tier called messaging, where we are actually handling part related to middleware. So here we are routing data, transforming data, aggregating data, and then we are sending it to processing tier, where you can build different metrics, build real-time metrics, or run historical queries over your data. Of course, we will need some sort of data storage, and the main quality of that storage should be high availability and security. And essentially, to build, for example, client applications so connected to your BI tool, we will need some sort of backend logic tier, where we will actually implement applications that will query the data or actually build some rules over the data. Of course, if we are speaking about client tier, so there we can build different web applications, mobile applications. So client tier is not limited to any particular technology or direction. Here we want just to show that we can interconnect our platform to basically any representation you want, including existing BI tools like Tableau, Google, Data Studio, Power BI, or any other. Okay, moving to business benefits. As I've said, such modular approach will help to save up to 45% on design and MVP implementation. Because basically you will get infrastructure within days. So we have everything automated. That means that we can provision infrastructure really fast. And basically we reserve just a couple of days in order to fine tune our automation scripts and actually make it according to your specific requirements. That's all, of course, reduces MVP go-to-market time, because you can start implementing your business flows and you can start building your business logic from the very beginning. So you will not have any intermediate results. You can actually start building applications from the very beginning. Of course, that decreases management costs, and we don't use any specific technology in our architecture. So we use well-known solutions. They are all well-known on the market. So I will show you on the next slides how we achieve that. Speaking about cost benefits, in time we can save up to 8 weeks of development, because as I said, we have automated our provisioning scripts, we developed integrations, and actually we have application skeletons that can work with our data processing and data storage tiers. Speaking about running cost, so we measured that single environment may cost you from $500 for MVPs. For medium-sized businesses, let's say you have like 10,000 devices that should be connected to your platform, and you would like to run different queries and build different metrics, that may take around $2,000 for production environment. And for big enterprises, we can offer solutions that will cost around $4,500. And that's just for operations in specific cloud. So basically, we can optimize cost based on your concrete requirements. And of course, it depends on how many data you generate and how many users you have within your platform. So that's just basically a starting point for discussion. So we are not limited to like particular number, but just to give you a sense of how much will it cost, we provided such estimates. As a part of our technical excellence, we actually thought about 6 main qualities for our platform. First of all, we think about high availability for data processing and for data storage tiers. Because if you cannot access your data, you cannot build metrics, you cannot access real-time dashboards, you cannot run queries. Of course, that affects any type of business. Then one of our key qualities was scalability and performance. So basically, we were thinking, how can we apply our platform to different business size? How can we support from 100 queries per second up to millions queries per second, right? So that's an important stuff. How can we scale our architecture to support such requirement? Then actually what essentially drives our architecture is modularity and modifiability. So basically, how can we modify our tiers? How can we change different modules within those tiers? How can we redeploy without any effect to business? So we thought about different scenarios and different cases when we need modularity and modifiability. Of course, we understand that businesses may have existing technology stack and existing BI tools. So we need to think about interoperability. So how can we connect our platform to different tools? How can we build different clients? How can we achieve that? It's an interesting question, right? About privacy and security, basically, how can we protect the data? Because securing edge devices, securing data, transmitting to the platform and storing into the platform is a key requirement for any kind of platform, right? And last but not least is operational efficiency. So basically, how can we optimize running cost? How can we build a platform that may be customized on flight without redeploy? So particularly data processing tier and data collection tier. Okay, so let's take a closer look. Actually, it was mentioned that our architecture was designed as a cloud agnostic approach from the very beginning. We don't limit ourselves with constraints and limitations of existing services. So our thought process was that we first define components and their responsibilities, and only after that we build and select services that actually will perform that role. So speaking about data collection tier, for example, we will need some sort of balancers in order to capture any event from our edge devices. We need a data collector model, data collector thing that will actually take all of the data. In messaging tier, we would like to have some sort of message bus that basically routes the data from our edge devices to processing tier. And speaking about two tiers, processing tier and data tier, we are following what is called Lambda architecture in big data space. So basically, that's a type of architecture where you have essentially two main streams. The first stream is for real-time analytics, so it's called like speed layer. And as for batch processing or historical queries, we will have another layer that actually called batch layer or batch processing. And then in data tier, actually, we have different types of storages. So essentially, processing tier and data tier combines data warehouse, data processing, caching, and raw data. Last but not least, backend tier. Here we may actually propose different types of architectures, different types of structures. So here we may have service-oriented approach, or may have some sort of microservices that will suit for some low-level specific operations with the data, and so on. Okay, so let's take a look into concrete architecture. So, as I said, first we built cloud-agnostic architecture, but then we transformed it into specific architectures for different clouds. So on the screen right now, you see AWS version of our architecture. And this architecture is suitable for what we call rapid starts. So basically, this type of architecture helps you to start project as fast as possible. As a core of our whole architecture for processing tier and data tier, we selected technology called Apache Druid. So it's a high-performance, real-time analytics database. It suits well for IoT data. It has all the capabilities for real-time analytics, for sub-second queries, and provides many interesting features that may be suitable for intelligent data processing. As part of our architecture, also here we used multiple managed services. So, for example, for data collection tier, we suggest to start with AWS IoT Core as a basically service that can operate with different protocols and different types of edge devices. And as for messaging tier, here we selected Apache Kafka, but managed version of it from AWS called Amazon MSK. So that means that if your business has, for example, existing data collection tier, so for example, you're already collecting the data out of your edge devices, we can just keep data collection tier from our platform, and all we need to do is integrate your existing components with our messaging tier. If you don't have data collection tier, we can provide an option to set up, for example, as we said, AWS IoT Core, or for example, build any custom data collection models if needed. Speaking about backend tier, right now our skeletons are written in Python. So we wrote a special application that connects to Apache Druid, or actually to processing tier, and takes all required data and metrics. But we are not limited to that language. Again, if you have any preferences on backend languages, we can rewrite the tier using your language. And actually, as I said, here on the screen, we are showing option how we can connect it with Tableau and how we can connect it to different web clients or mobile clients. So it's also feasible to do with this platform. Okay, Sounds too suspicious, right? Lots of benefits without any proofs. For that reason, we actually built a prototype that uses our platform to demonstrate our capabilities. We selected energy management domain, and with help of our platform, we built end-to-end scenario for electricity consumption management across set of buildings with hundreds of devices. Actually, our solution shows multiple dashboards for different roles like operational manager or building owner to demonstrate real-time capabilities and reporting capabilities. Specifically, for example, energy consumption per building, device energy consumption for some specific period, total consumption, and real-time device consumption. So, hope that was interesting insights of our platform, I hope now you can see how we can accelerate essentially any type of project using our accelerator. And of course, you can use this architecture as a reference for your own solutions, because here we, as I said, introduced new architectural style, and we did like a heavy job in terms of consulting and selecting appropriate services and building different tiers for future solutions. So now I am open to your question. Thank you, everyone.
That is great. Thank you, Denis. It was really insightful. Lots of details on the solution and the modular architecture in general. I have some questions from the chat for you, if you don't mind. And the first one sounds like this. You showed an example in the energy management sector. Does it mean your solution works only for this domain? And can it be used in other directions like manufacturing, smart homes technologies, and industrial IoT?
Thank you. It's a great question. Actually, our cloud agnostic approach transforms not only to technology choice, but also to different business domains choice. So as I said in the very beginning, we are focusing on patterns. So that means that we would like to generalize our approach and scale it to different business domains. And yes, we are not limiting only to energy management domain. We can use our accelerator for manufacturing, for healthcare, for smart homes, for any type of solutions where you have essentially hardware devices. And it doesn't matter whether it's a particular business domain. So our goal is to introduce end-to-end platform that allows you to build features rapidly. So you can bootstrap platform, and then you can start building UIs, you can start building clients, you can connect it to your BI tools and work with data intelligently.
Hope that's that great. Thank you. Question. It really does. Yes, thank you. It was exhaustive, I guess. Another question for you. Is it possible to integrate the platform with the existing company technology landscape? And what would be the approach?
Yes, it is possible. Definitely it's possible, because that was one of our quality for interoperability and modularity. So as I've said, on our tiers, in backend tier, we can use different languages. So essentially, core of our platform is processing tier and data tier. That means that after we routed the data to processing tier, after we did all of the processing aggregation and transformation, we can build any backend application that will consume the data. So again, if you have different technology stack, we can adopt our platform to what you have inside your existing business.
That's great. And the very last question that we have for you is, have you implemented projects using out-of-the-box IoT solutions like Azure IoT Central?
Yes, actually we have a different version of this architecture for Azure, and there we have multiple options what kind of services we may use. But yeah, essentially we can think about combining those services as well.
Thank you so much. I have no more questions from the chat. Thank you again for your report and for your presentation. It was really cool and insightful, especially the idea of being flexible and modular in terms of architecture and repeat development, especially the fact that it really reduces the time to market and the development costs, as well as the proof, which was, I guess, the essential idea of why it is so necessary to adopt such technology.